Come here. Come on. Yes, good girl. I don't just watch after children, you know. I am the caretaker of some of the youngest and silliest of souls, as I do think I mentioned. That includes adults who enjoy whimsy and fun. And yes, even some animals. Like my friend Luna, who ran off to frolic in the park tonight. I know she's back, because I can hear her trying to dig up her old bones just outside. I know just the bait to get her inside. This is her favorite ball. I wish you could see it because it glows in the dark. It looks so much like the real moon. And it bounces! It's tied to a young woman who my dear friend Erin Lillis tells us about. A girl that one day ran over, frightened, to say, "The moon is following me."
Oh, good. You're here. Please help. I'm scared. I don't know if you'll hear this, but I have some notes, some pics, and paired with evidence you can't rebut. I'll make my case so you'll believe the danger I am in is real. I hope that by the time I leave, you'll have listened to my appeal. I think the moon is following me. You'll think it's crazy, but it's true. 'Cause every night, it's light I see, no matter my point of view. 3 weeks ago, I saw it out, a crescent grin amongst the stars. I smiled back and went about my night, but something felt bizarre. The hair rose on my neck and arms. A chill ran down my legs and back. I know they talk of all its charms, but what if it's a maniac? Just hear me out, there's more to say. According to my notes, I found the moon again the next Tuesday, suspiciously behind a cloud. Although it changed its shape and height, I knew it was the same bright moon. And now when I go out at night, I try but can't avoid that goon. I made a mark in my date book whenever it appeared this fall. If you'll just take the briefest look, you'll see the dates. It was them all. It's always lurking, watching me round all the corners that I turn. Just looking at my social feed should raise some real and true concern. My every friend and follower that's posted vids or snaps or pics has caught the moon behind them, blurred, just staring like a lunatic. Of course, I told my parents first, and they believed what I revealed, but they told me it was our curse that there will be new things I'll feel. Like when the moon is high and full, I'll have the urge to scratch and chew. And though my eyes are brown and dull, they'll change to a more golden hue. My hair will grow all full and coarse. The nails will sharpen on my toes. My voice will drop until it's hoarse. I'll smell more things with my new nose.
That can't be right. It's just too weird. That makes me want to bite and growl. It is the moon that should be feared. I'll scream it, just shout it, bark and howl. Oh, wait. I think I see their point. I do feel stranger than before. My muscles tense. I crack my joints. I should have listened to the lore. I'll have to stop this silly plea. Because my new blue friend is lit. The moon was never following me. I've always been stalking it. Thank you.